ਇਹ ਪ੍ਰੋਗਰਾਮ ਪ੍ਰਾਈਮ ਏਸ਼ੀਆ ਟੀਵੀ ਦੀ ਪ੍ਰਾਪਰਟੀ ਹੈ। ਇਸ ਦੇ ਕੰਟੈਂਟ ਨੂੰ ਆਡੀਓ ਜਾਂ ਫਿਰ ਵੀਡੀਓ ਰੂਪ ਵਿੱਚ ਚੋਰੀ ਕਰਕੇ ਯੂਟਿਊਬ, ਫੇਸਬੁੱਕ ਜਾਂ ਹੋਰ ਕਿਸੇ ਮਾਧਿਅਮ ਰਾਹੀਂ ਵਰਤਣਾ ਕਾਪੀਰਾਈਟ ਕਾਨੂੰਨ ਦੀ ਉਲੰਘਣਾ ਹੈ। ਅਜਿਹਾ ਕਰਨ ਤੇ ਕਾਨੂੰਨੀ ਕਾਰਵਾਈ ਕੀਤੀ ਜਾਵੇਗੀ।
ਪ੍ਰਾਈਮ ਏਸ਼ੀਆ ਟੀ ਵੀ ਦੇਖਣ ਵਾਲੇ ਸਾਰੇ ਹੀ ਦਰਸ਼ਕਾਂ ਦਾ ਬਹੁਤ ਬਹੁਤ ਸਵਾਗਤ। ਦੋਸਤੋ, ਅਸੀਂ ਹਮੇਸ਼ਾ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਨਾਲ ਕਿਸੇ ਨਾ ਕਿਸੇ ਖਾਸ ਮਹਿਮਾਨ ਨੂੰ ਮਿਲਾਉਂਦੇ ਰਹਿੰਦੇ ਹਾਂ। ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਅਗਾਂਹ ਵਧੂ ਸੋਚ, ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਅਚੀਵਮੈਂਟਸ ਨਾਲ ਤੁਹਾਨੂੰ ਰੂਬਰੂ ਕਰਾਉਂਦੇ ਰਹਿੰਦੇ ਹਾਂ। ਉਸੇ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਅੱਜ ਦੇ ਸਾਡੇ ਖਾਸ ਮਹਿਮਾਨ ਨੇ ਜੀ, ਮੈਂਬਰ ਪਾਰਲੀਮੈਂਟ ਆਫ ਮਿਸਿਸ ਅਗਸਟ ਸੈਂਟਰ, ਉਮਾਰ ਉਲਗਬਰਾ। ਕਰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦਾ ਸਵਾਗਤ। ਮਿਸਟਰ ਉਮਾਰ, ਇਟਸ ਵੈਲਕਮ ਟੂ ਅਵਰ ਸਟੂਡੀਓ।
ਇਟਸ ਗੁੱਡ ਟੂ ਬੀ ਵਿਦ ਯੂ।
ਯਾ, ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ ਸੋ ਮੱਚ ਫੋਰ ਕਮਿੰਗ। ਐਂਡ ਫਸਟ ਆਫ ਆਲ, let's start from your childhood, that you, as I know that you're born in Syrian family in Saudi Arabia. So tell me something about your childhood and what brings you in Canada.
First of all, I want to thank you. I want to thank Prime Asia Television and your audience for giving me the
thank
opportunity
so
to come and speak with you.
It's an honor to.
You know, my story is typical to many people. Many immigrants who've come to Canada.
Okay.
I'm of Syrian parents. I was born in Saudi because my dad at that time was working in Saudi Arabia like many expats. He was in the construction business.
Okay.
And I went, finished, I went to primary and secondary school there. Growing up like a typical middle class family, I was privileged. My parents provided for us. My mom was a stay at home mom.
Okay.
I have three sisters. Never ever expected to travel abroad. We traveled abroad on vacation, but never to move abroad. And I came to Canada to study university.
Okay, so
on my own.
So that means you came here for study?
Correct.
Okay.
Yeah, I went to Ryerson University. Mm-hmm. I studied mechanical engineering.
Okay.
At Ryerson University.
So, do you study as a in Canada? So, what brings you in your mind that you wanna be a politician?
Oh, it never really started that way. My parents thought I would finish engineering and I would come back.
So, your plan was to go back?
That was at least my parents' plan. My plan was, let me find out if I like where I am. If I like Canada, I may want to stay.
So, did you find any difference in Canada and Saudi Arabia?
Oh, of course, huge difference. You know, there's cultural difference, there's weather difference, there's language differences. So, not having friends or family. So, there were a lot of differences and a lot of challenges.
Okay. So, what brings you this side?
You mean in politics? I studied engineering. A typical Middle Eastern family expects their kids to either go into medicine or engineering.
Okay.
And I studied mechanical engineering because I thought this is something that I would want to do professionally.
Okay.
And I graduated. I found a job with Ainsworth Engineering Company. And I went on to do my Master's of Business Administration.
Okay.
Because I moved into the business side of the engineering. Never ever expecting to
be a politician
or even get involved in politics. But then, you know, with time, I started asking myself questions. Maybe I had too much free time.
Mm-hmm.
What can I do in society? And I started volunteering. I started volunteering with different organizations, with a youth organization, with a multicultural organization.
Okay. So you start participating in that one?
Correct, correct. And then part of that volunteerism, we would talk about, there are some social problems. How can we advocate for policy change?
Mm-hmm.
And always the conversation says, let's go meet with your MP. Let's go meet with your MPP.
Mm-hmm.
To advocate for policy change, to talk about our experience, to talk about our perspective.
Okay.
And then I met with politicians and I realized, they're humans just like everybody else.
So there's a way to go.
Yeah, and how important it is to connect with politicians,
mm-hmm.
and to advocate and to share your story with them.
Okay.
And then I started thinking, you know, there are some politicians that I really like and agree with, some politicians that I don't really agree with.
Okay.
I should really do something to help the people I agree with.
So you want to say somewhere different, that you want to create something different in that community.
Yes, and I wanted to help the people I agreed with. I wanted to help politicians that I agreed with, because I realized they don't just automatically get elected. They need support, they need volunteers.
They need to do something for the community as well.
That's correct, and they need to hear from their community members. Mm-hmm. The community, the politician has a responsibility to serve the community, but also the community has a role to be in contact with the politician, to always advocate, to always share their story with them. And so, that experience really opened up my eyes about the world of politics.
So where Omar start from?
From my mother.
Oh, okay.
And it was really organic. I never ever imagined
that. I think this is the family values that you comes from.
Yeah, it was obviously, I was raised on being a positive contributor to my neighbor community, to my neighbors. I was raised to care about myself and others, and I was raised to know that whatever happens in my community has an effect on me. Mm-hmm. So if I want to have a better life for myself, true, I should make sure that my community is doing well, because that's the best way for me to do well.
Yeah, so you are the one member that is belongs to student community, right? So how do you take their problems and how you solve them?
Well, you know, first, when the disaster in Syria, the political war that started in Syria six and a half years ago, mm-hmm, happened, it was heartbreaking for me to watch.
It was,
the
to everyone, actually.
Yeah, for sure. And I never imagined it would be this long. To this day, millions of people being displaced, hundreds of thousands of people dead, millions injured. So it was a real tragedy for me. And it touched home, you know, because my mother still lives in Syria today.
Oh, she's still in?
She's still in Syria today.
Oh, okay.
So is one of my sisters, is still in Syria today.
Oh, okay.
My grandmother is still in
That's
Syria
That's the hard
today.
Part for you.
For sure, for
yeah,
sure.
Because you are a member of parliament in Canada, and she is there. That's a hard part.
Yes, for sure. And I feel helpless most of the time. Okay. But that also energized me to do what I can do. Because one thing I learned in politics is that there are a lot of problems.
True.
And if you take all these problems in, you become paralyzed because you can't solve everything.
True.
But you can make incremental change. One step at a time, take one bite at a time. And I realized that at least, you know, I was proud to be part of a government that offered relief to almost 45,000 Syrian refugees over the last year and a half, including Canadian public. Canadian public stepped up and sponsored so many Syrian refugees. So it was heartening to see Canada rise to the occasion, open up its door, especially at a time when the world seems to be closing its door on each other, mm-hmm, turning our back on each other. I was proud, and still am proud, to be part of a country, to be part of a government that receive people who are in desperate need. Mm-hmm. So, you know, my office and I try to help as much as we can. There are so many people struggling to find places to live, jobs, need to navigate through immigration issues, sponsor the rest of their family. So we try to help. We try to assist them in finding jobs, finding accommodation. We worked with also charitable organizations that provided support to those newcomers. So we're trying our best to help them.
Okay, very nice to talking to you, but it's a time for break now. So let's take our small break. So break to baad wapas padte hain.
Bahut vishal hai khabran da is sansar. Kade sach di khabar te kade kach di khabar. ਕਦੇ ਦੁੱਖ ਦੀ ਖਬਰ ਤੇ ਕਦੇ ਭੁੱਖ ਦੀ ਖਬਰ ਪਰ ਹਰ ਖਬਰ ਦੇ ਪਿੱਛੇ ਲੁਕੀ ਹੁੰਦੀ ਹੈ ਇੱਕ ਖਬਰ ਜਿਸ ਦੀ ਗੱਲ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਅਸੀਂ ਪ੍ਰੋਗਰਾਮ ਖਬਰ ਦੀ ਖਬਰ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਪ੍ਰਾਈਮ ਏਸ਼ੀਆ ਟੀਵੀ ਤੇ ਸੋਮਵਾਰ ਤੋਂ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਸ਼ੁੱਕਰਵਾਰ ਤੱਕ ਹਰ ਰੋਜ਼ ਟੋਰਾਂਟੋ ਟਾਈਮਿੰਗ 8:30 ਸ਼ਾਮੀ ਤੇ ਇਸੇ ਟਾਈਮ ਵੈਨਕੂਵਰ
ਸੋ ਬ੍ਰੇਕ ਤੋਂ ਬਾਅਦ ਇੱਕ ਵਾਰ ਫਿਰ ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਸਵਾਗਤ ਹੈ ਗੱਲਬਾਤ ਚੱਲ ਰਹੀ ਹੈ ਮੈਂਬਰ ਪਾਰਲੀਮੈਂਟ ਆਫ ਬੀਸੀ ਸਾਗਾ ਉਮਾਰ ਅਲਗਬਰਾ ਜੀ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ ਉਹ ਦੱਸ ਰਹੇ ਨੇ ਕਿ ਸੀਰੀਅਨ ਲੋਕਾਂ ਦੇ ਲਈ ਕਿੰਨਾ ਮੁਸ਼ਕਿਲ ਹੈ ਉੱਥੇ ਕਿੰਨਾ ਅੱਜ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਦੇਖ ਰਹੇ ਹੋ ਕਿ ਕਿੰਨੀ ਉੱਥੇ ਗੋਲਾਬਾਰੀ ਹੁੰਦੀ ਆ, ਐਵਰੀ ਡੇ ਉੱਥੇ ਗੋਲੀ ਚੱਲਦੀ ਆ, ਬੱਚਿਆਂ ਨੂੰ ਕਿਸ ਤਰੀਕੇ ਨਾਲ, ਔਰਤਾਂ ਨੂੰ ਕਿਸ ਤਰੀਕੇ ਨਾਲ ਤੰਗ ਹੋਣਾ ਪੈਂਦਾ, ਅਤੇ ਕਿਸ ਤਰੀਕੇ ਨਾਲ ਇੱਥੋਂ ਦੀ ਗਵਰਨਮੈਂਟ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਹੈਲਪ ਕਰਨ ਦੀ ਕੋਸ਼ਿਸ਼ ਕਰ ਰਹੀ ਹੈ, ਪਰ ਕੁਛ ਲੋਕ ਉਸ ਦੇ ਖਿਲਾਫ਼ ਵੀ ਜਾ ਰਹੇ ਨੇ. ਸੋ ਅਗਲੀ ਗੱਲਬਾਤ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਬਾਰੇ. ਸੋ ਮਿਸਟਰ ਅਲਗਬਰਾ, ਸਮ ਪੀਪਲਸ ਦੇ ਲਾਈਕ ਇਟ, ਲਾਈਕ ਦੈਟਸ ਓਕੇ ਟੂ ਹੈਲਪ ਦਿਓਰ ਸੀਰੀਅਨ ਪੀਪਲਸ, ਬਟ ਸਮ ਪੀਪਲਸ ਆਰ ਸਟੈਂਡਿੰਗ ਅਪੋਜ਼ਿਟ, ਦੇ ਡੋਂਟ ਵਾਂਟ ਦੈਮ ਟੂ ਕਮ ਹੇਅਰ. ਸੋ ਵਟ ਇਜ਼ ਯੋਰ ਪੁਆਇੰਟ, ਲਾਈਕ ਵਟ ਯੂ ਵਾਂਟ ਟੂ ਸੇ ਔਨ ਦਿਸ?
You know, Canada has a proud history of receiving refugees and immigrants from all over the world. Last year, we received a record number of over 300,000 newcomers. So some of them, 40-some thousand, are Syrian refugees, but the overwhelming majority, over 300,000, come from all over the world. And what we know over these years, that those newcomers, refugees or immigrants, have added tremendous value to our country, right, and have participated. They brought in skills, they brought in passion, they brought in energy, right, and they brought in determination because they feel they have something to prove.
That's right.
And they've built up our country. So, you know, and from a refugee standpoint, we've had people from Vietnam, we've received people from Africa in the past, we received people from Sri Lanka, we received people from all over the world at a time of need.
Even and so many Syrian peoples are coming as well. Justin Trudeau is giving them the way.
Yeah, so it's about 40-some thousand people from Syria. And it's, so first of all, it's part of our international obligation. The rest of the world is receiving, Germany has received over a million, and many other countries in Europe and around the world have done that. Canada stepped up to play a role to help. There's over 7 million displaced Syrians.
Okay. So
it is actually the largest and biggest human disaster that is ongoing today. So no doubt there are other problems around the world and people as well need help too.
But the main concern is about the Syrian these days especially.
Correct. It's the biggest problem, but we also have other problems in Africa. We have other problems in Myanmar. We have problems in Egypt and other places. And we are receiving and welcoming people who are in desperate need from there as well. So we just got to remind ourselves that this is not only is it a good thing for the world, but it's also a good thing for Canada. You look back over the last decades, how those people, and one of the things that make me most proud is Vietnamese families were sponsoring Syrian refugees.
Oh, really?
Those Vietnamese families who were welcomed here a few decades ago.
Because they, I think they understand their pain.
Exactly.
Because they've gone through this.
Yeah,
so
we received almost double the amount of Vietnamese people a few decades ago. And those families knew exactly what you just said, knew that need and that desperate need that those families, and for them to step up. So, there's no doubt that we are always going to have this conversation in our society. It's good. But overall, half of the refugees that came here, half of the Syrian refugees, were actually sponsored by Canadians.
Oh, really?
Canadians themselves put together money, brought their families together and said, we are watching what's happening. And we're stepping up and we're welcoming families who are in desperate need.
So how government contribute to bring them here? Do they give them proper like jobs or the, giving them, how they help them actually?
So half of the refugees, that Syrian refugees that came, were sponsored by Canadians.
Okay.
And those Canadian families were responsible for providing them for shelter and assistance for up to a year.
Mm-hmm.
And the other half was sponsored by the government.
Okay.
And also it's the same thing. They are provided with a stipend, mm-hmm, some initial accommodation for up to a year. And then after a year, they are expected to hopefully find jobs on their own, to settle in, find accommodation on their own.
Oh, that will be, I think, great idea to bring them here. Maybe they can better contribute in Canada as well. So if you will talk, we come to Canada. Okay, we'll talk about Mississauga. So how that problems comes to you, that like if the issues going on in Mississauga, so how you solve them, how you take them, how you solve them?
Well, a lot of people come to my office to help with files they have with the Canadian government. Mm-hmm. So basically, it's immigration, it's permanent residence, it's citizenship, it's visa for their families, it's sponsorship, spousal sponsorship.
Okay.
Also taxes, if they have anything with Canada Revenue Agency, pension issues. So those are the matters that have to do with the federal government.
Okay.
You know, our system is complicated because we have also a provincial level government and we have municipal level government.
Right.
So sometimes people are confused which level of government is supposed to address.
Mm-hmm.
They come to us, we try to assist them, and we tell them who can help them.
Okay.
But we advocate very hard for people who come to us. If there's an issue that is stuck with the federal government, we go to bat for them. We fight for our constituents.
Mm-hmm.
Overall, people in my riding are concerned about people who are looking for jobs. Obviously, they need jobs. People who are concerned about the economy. People are interested in affordability, cost of living, especially with the rising in the house price, housing prices in Mississauga. So these are the issues.
So these are the different complaints that people are comes with.
For sure.
Okay. So they are satisfied with when you serve them?
I hope so. I mean, I try to follow up with every person who comes to my office. We send a letter thanking them for coming to the office, and then we ask them to provide us feedback.
Okay.
So we try our best. Maybe you should ask them, but I'd like to think that they are satisfied.
So I think you get the better feedback.
Yes, we're getting very positive feedback. But obviously, there's always work to be done. There are times when, unfortunately, we can't assist somebody. So we explain to people why this is outside of our powers or outside of our jurisdiction.
So any issues that you are working on that in Mississauga, that issues that you see there, that I want to fix this, I want to fix that?
One of the issues that I'm looking forward to seeing is we don't have in Mississauga for entrepreneurs, people who are starting a new business.
Mm-hmm.
We don't have a space for them called an incubator,
mm-hmm.
where small businesses come together and talk about how to start a business.
Okay.
Combine resources, combine advice.
Okay.
There are many spaces across the GTA. But we don't have one in Mississauga.
Okay.
I'm hoping, you know, Sheridan College and the city of Mississauga and myself are working on maybe collaborating, starting a new space like that.
Okay, we'll talk about that, but it's time for break now. So let's take a small break. Choti ji break to baad bolde hain.
Tuhaddi te saadi, yani ke saadi saryan di zindagi naal sambandhit masle, kujh desh de, kujh pradesh de, ਕੁਝ ਵਿਦੇਸ਼ ਦੇ, ਕੁਝ ਇਤਿਹਾਸ ਦੇ, ਕੁਝ ਮਿਥਿਹਾਸ ਦੇ, ਕੁਝ ਸਮਾਜ ਦੇ, ਕੁਝ ਰਾਜਨੀਤੀ ਦੇ, ਕੁਝ ਚੰਗੇ ਵੀ, ਕਦੇ ਕਦੇ ਮਾੜੇ ਵੀ। ਅਸੀਂ ਸਾਰੇ ਮਸਲੇ ਵਿਚਾਰਦੇ ਹਾਂ। ਤੁਸੀਂ ਦੇਖ ਸਕਦੇ ਹੋ ਸੋਮਵਾਰ ਤੋਂ ਸ਼ਨੀਵਾਰ ਤੱਕ ਪ੍ਰੋਗਰਾਮ ਪ੍ਰਾਈਮ ਡਿਸਕਸ਼ਨ ਐਟ ਪ੍ਰਾਈਮ ਏਸ਼ੀਆ ਟੀਵੀ।
ਬ੍ਰੇਕ ਤੋਂ ਬਾਅਦ ਇੱਕ ਵਾਰ ਫਿਰ ਤੁਹਾਡਾ ਸਵਾਗਤ ਹੈ। ਬਹੁਤ ਹੀ ਦਿਲਚਸਪ ਗੱਲਾਂ ਚੱਲ ਰਹੀਆਂ ਸੀ ਮਿਸਟਰ ਅਮਾਰ ਅਲਗਬਰਾ ਜੀ ਦੇ ਨਾਲ। ਸੋ ਉਹੀ ਗੱਲਬਾਤ ਆਪਾਂ ਕੰਟੀਨਿਊ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਾਂ। ਸੋ ਮਿਸਟਰ ਅਮਾਰ ਅਲਗਬਰਾ, ਯੂ ਵਰ ਫਾਰਮਰ ਪ੍ਰੈਜ਼ੀਡੈਂਟ ਆਫ ਕੈਨੇਡੀਅਨ ਅਰਬ ਫੈਡਰੇਸ਼ਨ। ਸੋ ਟੈਲ ਮੀ ਅਬਾਊਟ ਦੈਟ ਐਕਸਪੀਰੀਅੰਸ।
ਸ਼ੋਰ, ਦੈਟ ਵਾਸ ਪਾਰਟ ਆਫ ਦ ਟਾਈਮ, ਰਿਮੈਂਬਰ ਵੈਨ ਆਈ ਟੋਲਡ ਯੂ ਆਈ ਸਟਾਰਟਡ ਵਾਲੰਟੀਅਰਿੰਗ ਵਿਦ ਡਿਫਰੈਂਟ ਆਰਗੇਨਾਈਜ਼ੇਸ਼ਨ ਐਂਡ ਦੈਟ ਵਾਸ ਐਨ ਆਰਗੇਨਾਈਜ਼ੇਸ਼ਨ ਆਈ ਸਟਾਰਟਡ ਵਾਲੰਟੀਅਰਿੰਗ ਵਿਦ ਦੈਮ ਟੂ ਐਡਵੋਕੇਟ ਫੋਰ ਦੀ ਇੰਟੀਗ੍ਰੇਸ਼ਨ ਆਫ ਅਰਬ ਕਮਿਊਨਿਟੀ ਵਿਦ ਇਨ ਕੈਨੇਡਾ। And then because I was so active, I ended up becoming the president. I was elected for one term as the president. And it was really a fascinating experience. In fact, it was the best political course I've ever taken. I've never studied formal political science. But you know, when you work with many members of the community, different points
of
views.
So you learned lots of things.
Yeah, different points of views, different stakeholders, different arguments, different fights. It was really a useful experience for me, and I feel I added some value.
I think I like the way you said, like, I really want to be a politician now. So, okay, so how was the experience being a policy advisor with a senior policy advisor with Justin Trudeau?
I have lived a privileged life. I am very fortunate, and I still can't believe I'm sitting here across from you talking about my experience as a member of parliament.
Right.
I'm also a parliamentary secretary to the Minister of Foreign Affairs. I've lived a really good life, and I was lucky and privileged to have known Justin Trudeau years ago, to work with him, to become his friend, and been able to offer my perspective. He would he and I would talk about various things, particularly if concerned to the Mississauga area. So it's been a great privilege. And Mr. Trudeau is a very curious man. Yeah. He asks a lot of questions. So he doesn't just ask one question, and he doesn't ask superficial questions. Mm-hmm. He digs deeper. He wants to understand things very well. So it's been a privilege.
That's really great. Any future plans, like for the Mississauga?
You know, my vision of the Mississauga is that everybody lives with an opportunity to reach their own potential, mm-hmm. that they're treated fairly, that they're given equal opportunity. Because I believe if you give people the chance, they will succeed. Mm-hmm. Success is different for different people.
True.
So some women, perhaps success for them is stay at home mother or a CEO. Some men is stay at home father or CEO or a politician. Mm-hmm. So I want everybody to be given the chance to pursue what they desire, mm-hmm. and to be treated equally and fairly. Mm-hmm. So in order to do that, we need an economy that is growing, that gives people the chance, but also we need policies that treats everybody respectfully and equally. So we need both a working economy, but also social policies that opens up doors for everybody.
So is government is creating any jobs in Mississauga that to fight with the unemployment?
Well, I'm lucky to, happy to say that over the last 7 months, the job creation record has been the best in 10 years. So we're witnessing economic indicators, economic growth numbers, job creation numbers today, the best in more than 10 years. Okay. That doesn't mean everybody has a job. That doesn't mean we don't have any more problems. We still have issues. We still have challenges. But I'm optimistic about the future. And I am delighted that our government is focused, laser focused on that, and also making sure that our tax system is fair for everybody, particularly the middle class. Because for a long time, the top 1% got a lot of tax breaks, but the middle class didn't get the help that they needed. And I'm happy to be part of a government that is changing that, making sure that the middle class gets the help that they need.
That's really good. Anything that you're doing for youth, because as you know that like so many kids, they are doing drugs and so many stuff and going on. So anything that you're working on?
I am very, today I'm very proud of so many things. But one of the other things I'm very proud of is I have a youth council.
Okay.
There's a youth council made up of 18 people who advise me mm-hmm. on youth issues.
Okay.
And they come from different backgrounds, mm-hmm. different ages, from high school to university to professionals. Mm-hmm. We meet once a month. We've done different initiatives. We talk about all the challenges they face.
From so any seminars going on for the youth?
We've done a variety of things, and there's more coming. But we talked about discrimination in our society. We've done a lecture for discrimination and the history. Canada has some history that we're not very proud of, how we dealt with our Indigenous people. How in the past we've had discrimination against Chinese, against Ukrainians, against other groups.
And still going on.
But we had policies, government policies in the past. Mm-hmm. So we should learn from that. So we had these lectures and these seminars for our youth council. So yes, and it is an ongoing thing. So we're always looking for ideas. We're always looking for engagement. But my youth council is providing me with such valuable input that I'm very delighted to have them.
So how a youth contribute in this?
Well, they're driving it. They're the leaders for the youth council initiative. Mm-hmm. Last month, they came up to Ottawa. They visited me in Ottawa. Mm-hmm. They attended question period. Mm-hmm. They met with ministers. They met with parliamentary secretaries. They met with other group. And they're not only are they learning.
Do they talk about their issues that
yes.
like we are going with this issue and we want to quit this, we don't want to do this and we don't accept this?
Yes, for sure. We talk about various challenges, mm-hmm. whether it's the drugs use, whether it's jobs mm-hmm. For young people, whether it's even summer jobs. you know, many of them are still in school, but they need summer jobs. Mm-hmm. We talk about that. We talk about discrimination, mm-hmm. stereotypes, accommodation. Mm-hmm. We talk about all these things. Basically, their experience that they're going through as students or as young people, mm-hmm. they bring it to the table and we discuss it. And we also figure out where can government help and where can society needs to take leadership. We talk about all these things.
Okay. So anything that you want to tell me that I didn't ask you?
You asked a lot of good questions. Look, I, as I travel around the world, now I'm a parliamentary, like I mentioned, parliamentary secretary to the Minister of Foreign Affairs.
Okay.
So this job sometimes takes me around the world. I was just in Africa last...
Meeting lots of people.
2 weeks ago. Meeting people, meeting politicians. And I know how fortunate we are in Canada. People around the world now, there's a rise of, discrimination, xenophobia, closing the door, us versus them, tension. I come to Canada and I see, yes, we have our own challenges, no doubt. But because we're such a diverse nation.
Yeah, because people, they are scared from each other now.
Yes, around the world, people are here. While maybe some people try to create this fear, but overall, people work from different backgrounds together. People live next to each other. They have the Muslims, the Sikh, the Hindu, the Buddhist, the Christian, the Jew. They're living next to each other. They're working together. And
they want to be together. I think there's something that is separating them, but... They still want to be together.
Yes, and their kids go to school together.
Yeah.
So, even if maybe they hear bad things from other people, but then their son or their daughter comes from school and they bring their friends and they see how they're getting along together. Yes. It is a joy to watch. And it makes me proud. Mm-hmm. But we still have a lot more work to do. Yeah. We still have a lot more work to do. So, I am very proud of what we as a country have built together. And in fact, this diversity makes us stronger. I know the Prime Minister says that all the time. The reason why it makes us stronger is because everybody has their own unique experience. Sure. And that unique experience adds value to our country. It brings a new added perspective that maybe I would have thought of if you didn't share it with me. Yeah. But also, it humbles us because we know that we as humans have common goals.
Yeah.
We share the same values.
Right.
We want to do what's best for our families. Yeah. We want to live a healthy life. We want to live able to afford things for our family.
We want to be safe. We want to.
That's right.
Yeah, to stay together.
Exactly.
Right.
So we know that what brings us together is a lot more than what divides us. So it's a great country. But we need to continue to remind ourselves of how far we've come, and also we still have a long way to go.
Okay. That was really nice to talk to you, but time is ascending now. So on the end, do you want to say something to our viewers?
I just want to thank you and thank your viewers for being an integral part of our society. Canada is strong because, as I said, of our diversity, because of the various points of view. It doesn't mean that we all have to agree on the same thing, but we're all working towards the same goal. All these ideas, all that input, all that feedback is important to make our country strong. The rest of the world looks up to us for who we are. We should continue that pride and work together on making our country even greater.
So thank you so much, and most welcome in our studio, and thanks a lot for sharing your knowledge with us.
It's a pleasure. Thank you very much for the opportunity.
So, hun mainu deo ijazat, itthe hi program khatam karde haan. Sat Sri Akal ji, tusi dekhde raho Prime Asia TV, tada apna, tade layi.
If you like this video, please subscribe the channel, like and share this video.